everyone. So last class we were discussing about the basic concept of Carney's method, advantages, disadvantages of Carney's method over other methods, and also we have discussed the procedure to be followed to solve the problems on continuous beams and frames. So this is one of the displacement method. So here we will be finding the friction moments first. So that only I have listed out the steps to be followed to solve the problems. So step one, we'll be finding friction moment. Step two, we'll be finding rotation factor. How we have found the distribution factor in case of moment distribution method. So here we'll be finding the rotation factor. So similarly, this rotation factor depends on the relative stiffness. Okay, so it is given by minus 0.5 times K divided by summation of K, that is distribution factor. So step three, so you'll be finding the rotation moments. So as we discussed in previous class, this particular method is also known as rotation contribution method. So here we'll be finding the rotation moments in step three. So it is given by rotation factor into summation of friction moment at a joint plus summation of far end rotation moments. So lastly, we'll be finding the final moments. So given by the friction moments plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moment. So this formula similar like to your slope deflection equation. So 2EI theta by L, that is a rotation contribution what we'll be considering here in case of Carney's method. So let us solve one problem on continuous beam first using these steps. Okay. So let us solve a continuous beam by Carney's method. So I have considered A, B, C, D a continuous beam. So support A is fixed, support D is fixed, support B and C are simple supports. So if you find the degrees of freedom, that is degree of kinematic indeterminacy for the problem is 2, that is theta B and theta C, correct? So this is also one of the method where it depends on the degrees of freedom. It is also a displacement method. Okay. So, but the procedure to get or to analyze a particular beam, it is different. Okay. So here, step one, you will be finding the fixed end moments. So fixed end moments for AB span, BC span, and CD span. So completely making each individual span completely restrained. So we'll be finding out what will be the fixed end moments. So something like this. This is AB span. I hope you are perfect with finding this fixed end moments. Already you have solved problems on slope deflection method and moment distribution method. So similarly, here also we'll be finding the friction moments due to this load. So the deflection of this particular span will be something like this. There will be a sagging deflection Correct. So restrain this, the fixed movements, they will be always fogging. The load will be causing the beam to deflect downwards. These fixed movements will be always opposing to that. Correct. So this is MF AB and this is MF PA. Correct. These are the fixed movements. So we are having so different formula to calculate fixed moments depending upon the type of load. If it is acting at the center, concentric load, if the load is acting at a distance A and B, if UDL, if triangular load, if external movement. Okay, so we are having the formulas. So here, so MFAB. So if you consider clockwise as positive, so this MFAB is anti-clockwise. So you can consider it as negative. So what is the formula to calculate the friction moment for concentric load acting at the center? So it is WL by 8. So W is 50, L is 4 divided by 8. If you simplify this, you will be getting 25 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MFBA. So now it is clockwise. WL by 8 plus WL by 8. So we'll be getting plus 25 kilonewton meter. Okay. So these are the friction moments for span 1. Okay. Similarly, so you need to find friction moments for second span. So let me write it here. MFBC. So this is the load and span is 5 meters. The formula to calculate friction moment is WL squared by 12. So if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 31.25 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MFCB, it is plus WL squared by 12. So it is plus 31.25 kilonewton meter. Then last, there is a concentric load, so acting at a distance A and B, so that is eccentric load. Okay, so fixed moment MFC, the formula to calculate MFC is WAB square by L square. So if you simplify this, you will be getting MFCD as minus 57.6 kilonewton meter and MFBC as 38.4 kilonewton meter. So to calculate MFBC, W A square B by L square. So these are the friction moments MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, MFCB, then MFCD and MFBC. So in first step, we'll be calculating what will be the fixed end moments. Okay. So once you calculate the fixed end moments, then step two, so we'll be calculating the rotation factor. So we'll be calculating the rotation factor. So let us make this tabular column. Joint member relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness, then rotation factor minus 0.5 times K divided by summation of K. So this rotation factor will be found at the intermediate joints. So how we have found the distribution factor at the intermediate joints? So intermediate joint is one where the joint is associated with two spines, more than two also. Okay, that is intermediate joints. So if you look into this particular problem, so joint B and joint C, we can consider them as intermediate joints. The joint B is associated with BA and BC. Similarly, joint C is associated with CB and CD. So you need to find the rotation factor at joint B and also at joint C. So the members associated with joint B are BA and BC. BA, BC. With respect to C, it is CB and CD. CB and CD. So now we need to find the relative stiffness. So I hope you are aware about this relative stiffness. So it is the ratio of span to the moment of inertia to the span, correct? So it depends on the support condition. So with respect to this particular joint, the neck support, if it is fixed or continuous, it is I by L. With respect to this, the neck support, if it is simple roller or hinge, then it will be 3/4 of I by L. If it is fixed or continuous, it is I by L. If it is simple roller or hinge, then it is 3/4 of I by L. So already you have solved problems on slope deflection method and moment distribution method. So if we consider here with respect to B, the support A, it is fixed. Okay, so relative stiffness will be I by L. So here in this particular problem, moment of inertia is constant. They have not given different values. It is constant. So I by L. So B to A, it is I by L. L is 4 meters. Similarly, with respect to B, C joint, that is continuous. Why it is continuous? After this, there is one more support. If there is no support, then we could have considered this one as last support, that is simple. But here, after this, there is one more support. So we can consider with respect to B, C as continuous support. Okay, if that is the case, again, relative stiffness will be I by L. So span is 5 meters. Okay, similarly, with respect to C, the joint B, it is again continuous. Why it is continuous? After B, there is one more support. Correct? So it is continuous. If it is continuous, it is again I by L, I by Y. So lastly, with respect to C, B is fixed. If it is fixed, again I by L. So it is I by span is again 5 meters. Okay. So if you simplify this, summation of K, you will be getting. So that is simplify this. 0.45i. So this is 0.4i. Okay, then your rotation factor, that is minus 0.5 into distribution factor k divided by summation of k. So if you calculate, so you will be getting this as minus 0.28 and this is minus 0.22. This is minus 0.25 and this is minus 0.25. Okay, so one thing what we need to remember, at a particular joint, the sum of rotation factors, it will be always minus 0.5. Okay, so you can check it here, minus 0.28 plus minus 0.22. So ultimately it will be minus 0.5. Similarly here, at a particular joint, so it is minus 0.5. At C also you are getting minus 0.5. So, but in case of moment distribution method, when you have calculated the distribution factor, it was 1. Summation of distribution factors at a particular joint, it was 1. But here it will be minus 0.5. Okay. This is important thing what you need to understand here in step 2. That is rotation factor. Okay. So, once you calculate this rotation factor, then next step. That is step number 3, to prepare iteration table. So as we discussed in the last class, this is one of the method where it depends on iteration. Okay, so compared to the moment distribution method, here the error is nullified, so you will not be getting any particular error. So it is an iteration process. So this can be done with respect to Carney's box and calculation of rotation moment. Okay, so Carney's box and rotation moment you need to calculate. So you will be drawing the Carney's boxes. As we know, the square boxes, okay, something like this. So these are the Carney's boxes, so which will be drawn at the intermediate supports. So this is span as it is. So this is intermediate support. I will be drawing this Carney's box. Then again, this span as it is. Again, intermediate support. I will be drawing the Carney's box. Again, this span as it is. This is fixed head. This is also fixed head. So this particular beam is represented in such a fashion where we'll be accommodating all the fixed moments, rotation factor, the summation of fixed moment at a joint, and also we'll be calculating the rotation moments. Okay, so I will be drawing this in a bigger scale. So yeah, once you draw this Carney's boxes, so we need to have this all the once you draw the Carney's boxes, so then we need to show the fixed head moments, the rotation factor, and also the fixed head moment at a joint. So on this particular diagram, okay. So usually the fixed head moments will be written on top of this line, that is beam line, and summation of fixed head moment at a particular joint will be written here. The rotation factors will be written here, and also the rotation moments, they will be written here near to the joint. So let me write those values first. MF BAP, so it was minus 25. MF BA 25. This is joint B. BC, it is 31.25. So this is CB plus 31.25, and CD 57.6, and the last BC is 38.4. So last support is fixed here. Here it is fixed. Okay. So if they are simple roller or hinged, then we need to make some arrangements. But here they are fixed. Need not worry about that. So now once you write this fixed head moments on top of the line, so above this line, so this is an intermediate joint, and also this is an intermediate joint. So the summation of fixed head moment at this particular joint from BA and BC, this is MFBA, this is MFBC. So you need to write here MFBA plus MFBC. You need to write it here. So if you work out, this is 25 minus 31.25, you will be getting minus 6.25. So this is minus 6.25. Similarly, here 31.25 minus 57.6. Then if you add them, that is from this and this, right? So you will be getting minus 26.35. Minus 26.35. Okay, this is the fixed element at this particular joint, minus 26.35. Then rotation factors already have calculated with respect to the members, with respect to B to A, B to C, or BA member, BC member, similarly CB and CD, you have calculated. So you can write those values in this appropriate boxes. So rotation factor written here. So that was BA minus 0.28. So let me write it here, minus 0.28. So BC minus 0.22. Similarly, CB minus 0.25. So this is minus 0.25. So you may ask why these boxes are kept. Okay, these empty boxes will be used in case of when we solve a problem on frames. Okay, so if frame is there, so you can use like this. Okay, so multi-story building frame again. Here also column will be extended, that time they will be used this and this. But these boxes will be used to write the rotation factors only. Okay. Okay. So once you write this fixed end moments and rotation factors, then we need to start solving for rotation moments. Okay. So already we have discussed the rotation moment is given by rotation factor into summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus summation of fall in rotation moment. Correct. So this rotation factor is multiplied to this entire thing. Okay. Rotation factor into fixed moment at a joint plus rotation power in rotation moment. Okay. So again, these rotation moments will be formed at the intermediate joints. So with respect to joint B, the rotation moments I need to find are B to A, that is M dash BA. Similarly, I need to find M dash BC, B to A, B to C. So how you have calculated rotation factors? Similarly, you need to find this M dash CB and M dash CD. These are the values you need to find. So this is an iterative procedure where you will be calculating this rotation moments trial wise. Okay. So first trial, second trial, third trial. So as we come across the rotation moments, similar values in subsequent trials, so then we need to stop this particular procedure or calculation of rotation moments further. Okay. So whatever the values rotation moment you are calculating, M dash B to A, I will be writing it here. B to C, I will be writing it here. C to B, I will be writing it here. C to D, I will be writing it here. Okay, so let us say this is trial number one. So trial number one. So M dash BA, rotation factor. How much is the rotation factor for B to A? That is minus 0.28. Minus 0.28. Then summation of fixed moment at a joint. Where you are calculating? At joint B. So at joint B, what is the fixed moment? Minus 6.25 plus far end rotation moment, summation of far ends with respect to B. Which are the far ends? One is A and one more is C. So initially from this rotation moment is not there, zero. Similarly, here also it is not there, zero. Okay. So I'll be treating it as zero, zero, because they are not contributing anything to this to calculate rotation moment. Okay, so initially they are zero with respect to the far ends are A and C. So from here it is zero, from here it is zero. Okay, if you simplify this, so you will be getting 1.75. This is rotation moment. So I'll be writing it here, 1.75. Okay. So similarly, m dash b to c. So rotation factor, that is minus 0.22 minus 0.22. Pitch and moment at a joint. Still you are at joint B. This first subscript indicates at which joint you are calculating. So this is minus 6.25 plus. So again, with respect to B, the parents are A and C. So initial values, they are 0. So I will be writing it as 0. If you simplify this, you will be getting 1.37. So I will be writing it here, 1.37. So M dash CB, C to B. So now here it is 0. Now we are calculating at C joint. So these two are at B joint. Now you are calculating at C joint. So what will be the rotation factor, moments? Okay. So now M dash CB, rotation factor for C to B, it is minus 0.25. Minus 0.25. Pitch and moment at a joint, that is at C, minus 26.35 plus. Now this is important. Rotation moment from the parents. With respect to C, which are the parents? One is B and one more is D. From D, nothing. So initial value 0. From B, so already, so it has come from the joint B. Okay, so this is like distribution. Okay, so how we order the moment distribution method? Similar time. So already the value had come here. So that is 1.37 in first trial. So the same value, 1.37 plus 0. I will be writing it here. That is 1.37. So if you simplify this, you will be getting 6.24. Okay. So M dash CD, C to D. So it is again rotation factor minus 0.25. Minus 0.25. Pitch and moment at a joint minus 26.35 plus parent rotation moments. So which are the parents again? B and D. So from D it is 1.37. From D it is 0. That is 1.37. So again, if you simplify this, same value, 6.24. So I will strike out this. I will be using 6.24 here, CB. Similarly for CD, I will be using again 6.24. Okay, so these are the values, rotation moments we got in first trial. 1.75, 1.37, 6.24, 6.24. You will be getting these rotation moments only at the intermediate joints. Okay, so once you get this, so next iteration, that is second trial. So remember this formula. So try number 2. Okay. So rotation moment M dash BA, M dash BC, M dash CB, and M dash C. These are the four values we'll be calculating at a joint, and that is at intermediate joint. So BA, BC, CB, CD. So again, same rotation factor minus 0.28. Correct? B to A minus 0.28. Pitch and moment at a joint minus 6.25 plus summation of parent rotation moments. So which are the parents? One is at A, one more is at C. From A it is 0. From C, so now it has come value, that is 6.24. So I will write it here, 6.24. Similarly, minus 0.22, that is the rotation factor for BC. Then fixed moment at a joint, minus 6.25, plus parent rotation moments. With respect to B, again parent 0, and C from C, it is 6.24. Okay, so 6.24. Simply for this, you will be getting 0.003, 0.002. Okay. So I will be writing it here, 0.003. This is 0.002. So similarly, CB, rotation factor minus 0.25. Fixed element at a joint minus 26.35 plus far end rotation moments with respect to D. The far ends are D and D. From D it is 0, from B it is 0.002. You cannot use this 1.37. This already we have used in trial 1, whatever the value we have got. So now this is trial 2, the second value which has come just now, that is here. 0.002. So you strike it once you use it. Okay, it's better. So 1.37 already used. So now it is given 0.002 to calculate CB. So 0.002 is equal to. So how much you will be getting? So that is 6.59. Okay, similarly. Minus 0.25, fixed element at a joint 26.35 plus again far ends 0.002, 0. So ultimately it is 0.002. Simplify, it is also 6.59, same values, similar values. So I will be writing it here, 6.59. Okay. So this is with respect to trial 2. So we got the values. So if you compare the first and second, they are not similar. You need to proceed with this trials unless you are getting the subsequent values same. Okay. So since they are not same here, so let us go with next. Okay. So you already used this. Strike it. So trial number 3. Okay, so similarly, again M dash BA, this remains same, the rotation factor, fixed element at a joint remains same, then again far end, rotation, moments. Okay, these values will be different, only I will change this. Okay, so now the far end rotation moments, from B, far end A, far end C. So here it is 0, from this, that is 6.59. 6.59. So again for BC we are calculating again far ends 0, 6.59. So I hope you are getting the procedure how to use this. Okay. So if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 0.09. Minus 0.09. This is minus 0.07. Similarly, M dash CB. So this is same. Then with respect to C, the far end rotation moments. One is D, another is B. So from D it is 0, from B it is 0.002. 0.002. So here also 0.002. So how much you are getting? That is 6.60. So let us write these values. This is minus 0.09. This is minus 0.07. This is 6.60. This is also 6.60. Okay. So again, here 0.003 was there, minus 0.09 is there. So here 0.002, here minus 0.07, 6.59, 6.60, 6.59, 6.60. So here almost similar values. Okay. But here they are not similar, but they are almost nearly equal to 0. You can stop it here, but still, if you want to check it, so go for one more trial. That is trial number 4. Same thing. Only change this, then f dash da, so far end rotational moments. So here minus 0.07. So this is minus 0.07. Minus 0.07. Similarly here, from this, okay, 0.07. Oh, sorry. Yeah, so next one more trial, only these value will be changed. So, this is 0, from here it is 6.60. This is 6.60. Similarly, with respect to C, 0.07, 6. Sorry, it's here it is 0. That is minus 0.07, minus 0.07. Simplify this. So this is 0.09 minus 0.09. So here it will be 6.60. You just do this, you will be getting these values. Minus 0.09, minus 0.09. So this is 0.07. 6.60, 6.60. You can just check with the answers. So once you get this, so they are similar to the existing values. Okay. So we can make what of it. So this is also minus 0.09, minus 0.07, 6.6. This is also 6.60. Okay. These are the values. Ultimately, rotation moments will be considered to calculate the final moments. Okay, so that is the last step. Step number 4, to calculate final moments. So final moments are calculated with the formula fixed end moments plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moment. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate final moment. So final moment, so let us say if you are calculating MAB. Okay, MAB is equal to MFAB, fixed moment, MFAB, how much it is? Minus 25. Plus 2 times near end rotation moment. So with respect to AB, you are writing 9 kilonewton meter. Okay. So similarly, MBA. So B2A, MBA. So fixed end moments, here it is MFBA 25 plus 2 times near end rotation moment. So with respect to BA, B is the near end and A is the far end. So at near end it is minus 0.09. 2 times minus 0.09 plus far end is A. From A, rotation moment is 0. Simplify this, you will be getting 24.82. kilonewton. Okay, MAB minus 25.09, MBA 24.82. So once you get this, similarly MBC, MCB, MCD, MDC. So I will rub this. Remember the formula. Next, MBC. Okay, MFBC, that is minus 31.25 plus 2 times near end rotation moment. So you are adding B to C, which is the near end, B is the near end and C is the far end. So near end it is minus 0.07 plus far end, this is 6.60. I hope you are getting it. So M is your calculating. So near end, this is far end, rotation moment. Okay, B to C. So at B, near end is this. From C, far end is this. Okay, so it should be in the same span. Okay, when you are writing, it will be happening in the same span like this. Okay, so simply for this, you will be getting minus 24.79 kilonewton meter. Minus 24.79. Similarly, MCB, MC to be in the same span. So fixed element plus 31.25 plus 2 times. No, near end rotation moment. So this C is near end, B is far end. So near end it is 6.60 plus far end is minus 0.07. This must be equal to, you will be getting 44.38. Kilonewton meter. So lastly, last part, that is MCD, MFCD, that is minus 57.6 plus 2 times near end rotation moment, this far end is this, near end 6.60 plus far end is 0. Similarly, I will get this MDC, MFDC, that is 38.4 plus 2 times near end, it is 0, plus far end 6.60. If you simplify this, you are getting minus 44.40 and this is 45 kilonewton meter. So these are the final moments. When you say analysis, ultimately you will be finding what will be the moments developed at the support conditions. That is analysis. Ultimately, once you get this, so you need to find the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. You need to draw it by finding the reactions using your equilibrium conditions. Okay. So I hope this is clear. So next, let us draw the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram also. Okay. So for my reference, I will keep these values. So MAB it is 25.09 kilonewton meter. MBA it is 24.82 kilonewton meter. This is MBC. This is MCB, MCD, and MDC. Right. So these are the final moments what we got. Okay. So once you get this, now to draw actual bending moment diagram. I will consider my original beam. So let me try it again. So this is fixed. This is fixed, here simple support, here simple support, then what was the loading? Here 15, here it is 15, and here 80. This is 2 meters, this is 4 meters. This is 5 meters, this is 2 meters, and this is 2 meters. A, B, C, D. Okay. So this is our original beam. This beam we were analyzing. Ultimately, we got these answers. Now to draw actual bending moment diagram. So what is actual bending moment diagram? So this actual bending moment diagram, it is the superposition of pre-bending moment diagram and support moment diagram. So what is that? Pre-bending moment diagram and support bending moment diagram. So what is pre-bending moment diagram? So pre-bending moment diagram depends on the type of load acting on the span. Okay, and it will be always positive. So you will be drawing the pre-bending moment diagram by considering it as simply supported beam. Then similarly, support moment diagram. So this is with respect to the final moments, whatever you have calculated, that is nothing but the support moments. Okay, depending upon this, you will be drawing the diagram. Okay, so once you get these values, so it's better if you can make some directions for this. Okay, so this is minus. So what it indicates, we have assumed clockwise as positive. So this is anti-clockwise. This is plus clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. This is clockwise. This is clockwise. And this is clockwise. I hope it is clear. So even we have collected the answers. MCD it is minus. What was the value? How much it was? Just a minute. Let me check again. Yeah, it is minus 44. Minus 44.4. Minus 44.4. Okay. So this minus indicates it is anticlockwise. Okay, so once you make these directions, this is anti-clockwise, clockwise, anti-clockwise, clockwise, anti-clockwise, clockwise. So what you can do, you can put brackets on this. Okay, so MAB, it is anti-clockwise. MBA, clockwise. MBC, anti-clockwise. MCB, clockwise. MCD, anti-clockwise. MDC, clockwise. So once you get this, okay. So first let me draw the pre-bending moment diagram that depends on the loading. So here 50 kN concentrated load. So by considering simply supported beam, so if you consider draw the diagram, so it will be something like this, triangular variation. This is acting at the center, WL by 4. Similarly, this is UDL. This is parabolic. Maximum is WL square by 8. Then this AT acting at a distance A and B. And this is WAB by yes. So this is pre-bending moment diagram depending upon the load. Concentrated load acting at the center. So here UDL, here eccentric loading. Correct? So these are the values. You just substitute the values and calculate. Okay, similarly, support moments. So here arrow mark is not there. So I will consider MEB, it is 25.09. So this I will represent it with a single line like this. This is 25.09. So at B, that is 24.8. So MBA and MBC should be same with opposite sign. Slight changes after in decimals, so you can neglect it and you can write it only one. 24.8. Let me consider 24.8. So this is 25.09. So this line indicates the support moment at B, that is 24.8. Similarly, at C, 44.4. So that is more than this, somewhere up to this 44.4. And exactly at D, that is 44.4. That is let me write it as Let me consider 45. Okay, so join them. Okay, so if you join, this is the part where the positive and negative bending moment diagrams are superimposing. Okay, so these points where your positive diagram and negative diagram are superimposing, these are called as points of contraflexion. Okay, so if you want to draw the elastic curve, so it is just deflected shape of the beam. Here support condition is there, here support condition is there. So we can show these points on the elastic curve where your bending moment diagram changes its sign. So these points are called as points of contraflexure. Okay, so this is your actual bending moment diagram. Okay, superposition of free bending moment diagram and support moment diagram. Free bending moment diagram, they are drawn with respect to the loads acting on the span by considering simply supported beam, and support moments are drawn with respect to a single line, they will be always negative. So then just you have joined them. So you have superimposed the positive and negative diagram, and ultimately those points are called as points of contraflexion. This is with respect to actual bending moment diagram. So then you need to draw the shear force diagram. So to draw the shear force diagram, so you need to calculate the reactions first. So let me tell you the procedure how to calculate the reaction. This is a continuous beam. So you can cut a section at B. So after first support, you can cut a section at B. So from cutting the section at B, so consider the loadings. This is 50, this is RA. This is 2 meters, this is 2 meters. And here moment MBA is 24.82, and here MAB, that is 24.09. Okay, consider moment about B equal to 0. This is B. You are cutting the section at B. You can cut the section at any particular joint because ultimately it will be in equilibrium. So if you cut exactly at joint B, so you are cutting the section, consider left hand side. If it is clockwise, then it is taken as positive. So now you can calculate the reaction RA. So RA is looking clockwise moment, RA into 4 minus 50 into 2, then this is clockwise, plus 24.82, this is anti-clockwise, minus 24.09, this must be equal to 0. So simplify this, you will be getting how much is RA. Okay, same procedure. Now next, cut a section at C. Consider right hand side. You will be getting RD. Then cut a section at B. Consider exactly right hand side. So RD is already known. Only unknown is RC. Then apply sigma B equal to 0. You will be getting what is RB. Okay. So I hope you can do this. Once you get the values, then you can draw the shear force diagram. So just I will draw the nature of shear force diagram because I have not calculated the reactions. Okay, I hope you have done in slope deflection method and moment distribution method. So let me draw the nature. So RE may be like this. From here to here, no load, straight line. 50 may be coming downwards. From here to here, no load. Then RB upwards, something like this. This UDL, whenever you come across UDL, your shear force diagram changes its sign. It becomes from positive to negative. Total load 15 into 5, 75. How much is there here? So deduct that, you will be getting here. Then RC may be upwards. So no load, straight line. So coming downwards, straight line, and exactly come and meet here. That is positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. If you start it here, it has to end at here. It will come and meet exactly 0. Okay, since I have not calculated the reactions, so just I said the procedure how to calculate the reaction, because you already learned the slope reflection method and moment distribution method. I hope you have drawn the shear force diagram. So this is the way in which you will be drawing the shear force diagram. Okay, so this is with respect to Carney's method for continuous beam. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Let us solve a few more problems in next class, where the end conditions are different or the loadings are different. We can consider them and we can discuss them. Okay, thank you.